Hello and welcome to Yeyu Lab. If you have used OpenAI's O1 preview model, you might be surprised by the highest response quality among all the top class models. The O1 series models are designed to spend more time thinking through problems before responding, leading to more accurate and thoughtful answers, which are mainly contributed by its intermediate reasoning process. In OpenAI's tests, this reasoning-focused approach has shown impressive results. For example, when GPT-4o only solved on average 12% of problems for the math exam, the O1 preview model can average 74% with a single sample per problem, 83% with consensus among 64 samples, and even more when re-ranking 1,000 samples. Therefore, it's easy to conclude that a model trained with reasoning process can perform much better in resolving complex problems, particularly in science, math, coding, and engineering. In this tutorial, I will show you the entire training process of the very small model Llama 3.2-1B using a LoRa framework, Unsloth, and with the help of a dataset that contains 20,000 questions and responses containing a detailed chain of thought. As a result, we will see even such a small model can make basic reasoning steps and perform much better in thinking, examining, and correcting itself in a structured way. To be more practical, this tutorial will also consider the cost of training and inference to find out how to save money while reduce the huge usage of GPU memory as well as 2x faster speed. Unsloth is a powerful LoRa framework that can fine-tune large language models like Llama 3.2, Mistral, Phi 3.5, Gemma 2 with 2x faster while using up to 70% less memory. It achieves this through optimized kernel written in OpenAI's Triton language and a manual backprop engine without any loss in accuracy since it uses exact methods rather than approximations. The framework supports both 4-bit and 16-bit via bits and bytes and work on most NVIDIA GPUs. What makes Unsloth particularly attractive for cost-conscious users is that it can reduce GPU memory usage by 43% to 73% depending on the model while providing 2 to 4x faster training speed. This means significantly lower cost when using GPU cloud service as you can train models faster and with less expensive GPU options. To minimize the technical barriers to entry, Unsloth provides various lab notebooks to demonstrate the process of fine-tuning with different models and datasets. The demo in its tutorial is also based on the demo notebook of Llama 3.2 model. The model we will use in this video is Llama 3.2-1B instructor model, which is the smallest model in the Llama 3.2 family and is also considered one of the most powerful models in the portable model zoo. However, it's still a very limited scaled model that cannot perform reasoning steps even with the prompting technique. That's why, compared to the large models, it's the best choice for us to see how performance improvement can be achieved by enabling reasoning capabilities quickly. Let's see the dataset we will use. It's the reasoning base 20,000. That is a collection of 20,000 questions and responses. It's a detailed chain of thought in the additional reasoning column. So each entry of this dataset contains a user query, a corrected answer, providing the assistant column, and the most important, the reasoning column that give a detailed step-by-step reasoning process explaining how to arrive at that answer. And for the whole dataset, there are various domains included, for example, science, coding, math, and more. For the purpose of study and research in a cost-effective way, it is more than enough to demonstrate the effectiveness of reasoning capabilities based on this dataset. Now you can remotely connect to the server by SSH connection. First, we need to install the latest version of the UnSLOS framework by running these two install command that provided by UnSLOS notebook, which makes sure that you will download the repository directly from GitHub. Now let's start the training process. You can either run the training process on your own machine, Google Colab notebook, or on a cloud GPU service. In this video, I recommend to use the on-demand CPU cloud from Novita AI, which provides the low-cost rental of NVIDIA GPUs, including 4090, 3090, or 6000, or A100 GPU selections. And the price is very low according to the resources they provide. You just need a one-click button on the deploy to start a new server, and you can easily start or stop a server as your wish to prevent unnecessary costs. Meanwhile, your data and the system environment can be saved for up to 7 days at a very low cost, or you can save your images to the Docker cloud for future environment recreation. So it is really flexible and efficient platform. Here I used RTX 4090 24GB GPU for this training, and using the pre-installed environment with the PyTorch 2.2.1. Let's restart it. Now it's running. You will see the connection address and port and username and password from this connect button. So if my training will spend 1 hour, that will only cost me 35 cents for this environment. You can find my affiliate link of Novita AI in the description below. Thanks for the support. Now let's quickly check the code. Step one, pack a PEFT LoRa model. Here we use the UnSLOS Fast Language Model class to load the original Llama 3.2 1B instruct model and pack that original model into a PEFT model. So you can define the loading 4-bit parameter to true to reduce your memory usage. Here I set it as false because I have enough. And other parameters can be set to the recommended value by UnSLOS for necessary optimizations. And then let's update the tokenizer of Llama 3.2. Because the original model is not designed for the reasoning template, so we need to follow the basic Llama 3.1, 3.2 template to add an additional role and a message content for reasoning into the format of the chat template in the tokenizer. Then we should update the dataset. We download a dataset from the Hugging Face, King Niche Reasoning Base 20K, and use the updated tokenizer to restruct the dataset into a training compatible format. And we can print out the fifth row of the transformed dataset to verify the formatting. So let's run it right now. So you can see the structure, begin of the text, start header ID with user, and then start header ID with reasoning, and this is the entire reasoning content. And as a final result, there is another start header ID assistant followed by a context that provided by the final result. So that's exactly what we expect for the chat template. Now let's move to the next step. to set up the training arguments and the trainer. Here we use the Hugging Face's TIL API, SFT trainer, to set up the training arguments and create the trainer for training the Llama 3.2 1B model with the reasoning dataset. In this list of the arguments, we can flexibly adjust the training parameters to maximize the usage of our GPU resources and minimize the training time. For example, we can set the process batch size here per device train batch size to a bigger number to make the training process faster by sacrificing the VRAM usage, or adjust the gradient accumulation steps to control the memory consumptions by the batch processing. In this case, I will train the model with one epoch to reduce the time. Then we use additional function train on responses only from OnSlaw's library to update the trainer to focus more on the reasoning output. In the final step, we can start the training process by call the train function, and after the training complete, save the model into your local drive. Here I saved this model with a tokenizer into a Llama 3.2 1B reasoning folder for our later inference. So before we start the training, we can also add this piece of code to check the GPU memory usage at the end of the train. Now we can start the training process. So the fine tuning is at. We can see that there are totally 1,246 steps. In my environment, that will take me around 48 minutes to complete the whole steps. So if your training is successfully complete, you will find the model files together with the tokenizer and the config are all stored in your local drive. Now we can run an inference code to see how it performs the reasoning process. And here I have built a very simple code, which I use the standard Transformers API auto model for causal LM to load our saved model from our local drive folder together with the tokenizer. And I designed a prompt for a little complex problem of the coins weights measurement. You have 12 coins, one of which is counterfeit and weighs slightly different from others. You don't know if it's heavier or lighter. You have a balance scale. What is the minimum number of weightings required to guarantee you identify the counterfeit coin and determine whether it is heavier or lighter? And for the generation process, I separated it into two steps. The first step, I used the original user prompt with a setting add reasoning prompt to true in the apply chat template to let the model to generate the interim reasoning output. And after that, I pack this reasoning output into the next generation step and set the add generation prompt as true to let the prompt to generate the final answer based on the reasoning output. So let's see how it performs. So you will see for the first step, this 1B model is also capable of generating reasoning procedure, including understanding the problem, break down the problem, possible weighting strategies, and conclusion, self-reflection, and then use this content to generate the final answer, the minimum number of weightings required to guarantee the counterfeit coin is 6, which may not be correct due to the basic capabilities of this small model, but the process of reasoning could help it to think more. So considering you have another bigger model and fine-tune it with reasoning data set, it will generate better output for sure. That's all for today. For the tutorial and the source code, you can find the link in the description below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Keep innovating, and I'll catch you in the next one.